All right, let's do the helper video number 7. So, starting out with B and F atom, which has a higher Z effective? As we actually described in the lecture videos, the Z effective increases that way, right? And as the Z effective gets larger and larger, then the Z effective essentially means that what is the outermost electron feels, the positive charge in the middle of the orbit, right? So as the Z effective gets larger and larger, the atomic size gets smaller and smaller. Let me just try to give you just one example here. So for the B atom, you have 1s square, 2s square, 2p, right? So you have plus 5 in the middle, and then 2 electrons, and then everything else is on the outer orbit, right? N equal to 2, right? And each one of these electrons right here, she's a 5, that's 5 plus, minus 2. The two electrons in the core, right? 3 plus. That's Z effective right here, the 3 plus for the B atoms. If you work on the same case for the F atoms, then you're gonna have 1s square, 2s square, 2p, 5, right? Then 9 plus is in the middle, two electrons inside, and then rest of the stuff outside, the 7 of those guys, right? And each one of these guys actually she's a 7 plus charge. How did I get 7? 9 minus 2. So the F right here has a higher Z effective, and consequently the atomic size of the F is gonna be much smaller than B. So let's answer the question 1 and 2. And then general trend for the atomic size. So we just discussed the Z effective gets larger across the periodic table, right? So the Z effect, oops. Z effective increase, right? And also atomic size decrease. The reason why is that the atomic size is determined by where the outermost electrons actually orbit. And if the outermost electron sees the higher positive charge in the middle, it shrinks, right? Because that positive charge is going to draw those outermost electrons into the closer orbit, right? So the Z effective increase, atomic size decrease. And also, as you go down in a periodic table, the number of N increase, right? For example, like N equal 1, N equal 1, N equal 2, N equal 3, N equal 4, right? All of these things is gonna increase in size, right? Because as the N gets larger and larger, essentially you're increasing the size by putting more and more stuff on it, right? So, and also that N determines the size, so N equal 4 is at the outer orbit, right? So all of these things combined together, I would probably put it this way, like atomic size decrease as you go that way. All right, that's good enough for number 3. And then why the ionization energy is F is much smaller than NE. So that one right there, I just try to explain this one. So as you go across the periodic table, the ionization energy gets larger and larger, right? Because Z effective gets larger and larger. So for the F atom, you have a neutral, And then this is negative ion. The negative ion is always higher in energy than neutral. The reason why is that you are separating positive, well, maybe the negative and the rest of the stuff, which has to be positive. So positive and negative, you are splitting and then just trying to separate as much as possible, right? That's ionization energies. So more you separate, the energy gets higher and higher. And if you put all those things together in the same place, you form neutral. So neutral have zero separations. Negative ions, the positive ion is gonna be higher and higher. So positive and negative. The more detailed explanation is in the video, so watch that one too. And this is for the neon. You have the positive ions and then neutral. The gap gets larger here compared to the fluorine because that you're going across the periodic table, right? But it's not only that. It's, let's just think about the neutral neon case. You have a special configurations for the positive ions. Nothing special here. So the energy stays exactly where you expect it. But for the neutral, because of the nice configurations, good configurations, it's actually energy is much lower than where it's expected. So the gap right here is actually like this big. And for the fluorine, neutral, nothing special there. And then for the positive ions, nothing special there. So fluorine is exactly where you expect it and where you expect it. So the gap here is exactly where you expect it. So yeah, for that reason you can actually see that the big gap in the neons. So the neon energies, ionization energy is going to be much higher than fluorine. Okay, that's good. Alright, let's do the next one. Explain electron affinity. So the electron affinity is the opposite, more or less. You are trying to put the electrons to the neutral atoms. So the electron affinities, I'm going to shortcut this one, energy of the neutral minus energy of the negative ions. That's what it is. For this particular case, you have the neutral atom, right? And then you're trying to put electrons closer and closer together. So there is no positive negative interactions here. For the ionization energies, I go back, right? You have the neutral stuff to actually start with and then ripping off the electrons, right? So electrons are ejected out. That means that you're gonna have the positive charge here. So the interaction between here is a charge-charge interaction. Charge-charge interaction here. That's a strong force, attractive interactions. So electron affinity for this particular case, you see that the negative charge, but zero charge here. So the electron affinity is not really a charge-charge interaction. For that reason, electron affinity, the magnitude of the electron affinity is much smaller than the ionization energies. So that's one thing that I have to actually try to tell you. And then also, more electron you have, the lower the energies in general. So that's another thing that you might want to take a look at the videos and then convince yourself that's really the case. Now, there is a small periodic trend about the ionization energies, not the ionization energies, the electron affinities. For example, like in fluorine case, you have 9 plus in the middle, right? And then I have 2 electrons orbiting inside. And then there is 7 electrons, right? 5, 6, 7, right? 2s square 2p5, right? Right? 2s square 2p5. That's 1s square, right? So there is one extra spot, opening spot here, that you can actually shove the electron into. And that new electron is going to occupy right here. So that electron actually see in the middle of that orbit is a 7 plus right here. And that is the reason why that if you go across the periodic table, the higher the Z effective, because that's what this guy sees, right? That's what this guy sees in the middle, is the Z effective right here. So the higher the Z effective, it's easier for you to actually put that electrons if there is an opening spot. That's the key. If there is an opening spot, then it's easy to actually put the electrons. And now I'm going to go back to this particular things right here. Now, fluorine has a very high Z effective and then has an opening spot, right? So any one of these guys that's in here, right? All of those guys, very easy to put electrons because it has a high Z effective and opening spot. But for the neon and so on and so forth, that the noble gas is difficult to put the electrons because there is no opening spot. I think that's good enough for the helper number 7.